Said he wants to go to emulate his grandfather. It goes to the ball. It's a big right hand that comes in from Nico. Jordan Weeks is hurt. Arlie Walsh is slugging away upstairs. Big shot comes in again. Weeks is so defensively flawed. And this fight is over. A TKO victory for the grandson of the GOAT, Nico Arlie Walsh, against an overmatched Jordan Weeks, takes care of business, and the journey has...
That the offensive
end movement.
Nico Arlie Walsh, Norton, for his right hand, and that is putting in work tonight, and there's the combination, and the knockout for Nico Arlie Walsh in his fourth professional fight, close to Oklahoma. It may as well be his hometown, Tim.
Did you see the Arlie shuffle? You just saw the Arlie shuffle, and the left hook.
Nico came in, he didn't rush. Yes, he started with a body shot, went down low. Made Jagger forget about the hit, came back up, took a second to say, let me give you my version of the Arlie shuffle real quick. And then he came back with the Arlie shuffle right there. That made the referee get in there. Stopped the fight. Good stoppage from the ref. You can say, let it go on 102 more, but why? Great stoppage, great finish from Nico Arlie Walsh.
Nico, congratulations. He told us we were going to see a completely different fight. Is that what we saw? I think you did. I think the main thing was staying calm, which I did. Another thing was head movement and defense, which I felt like I could improve on. But you know what? I fought last month. So if I can make those small improvements in this short amount of time, who's going to tell me what I can do for my next fight?
Richard, come in here for a second.
You said you wanted to see him fight out of that little noon zone. Is that what he entered? Is that what he saw?
I think the crowd saw tonight that noon zone is going to go. He's, again, he used explicit language, but he's got that killer instinct. He's, I've seen him in the gym. He's knocked out pages of his sparring partners. He doesn't back down from anybody. He's still learning, and we're teaching him, and he's working very hard.
I have a question here. You came to this country to work with Joe Frazier. Now you gotta be the only guy who worked with Frazier. Got a kid doing the Arlie shuffle. You planned that one? No, I definitely didn't plan it. It was emotional, of course, because so much has been going on. I didn't plan on doing that. It's just something that happened.
What do you mean so much has been going on? It's been a tough time for you?
Trader change, a lot of talk? Yeah, no, definitely. It's been a super tough time, and that's no excuse. When you get in the ring, everything zones out, and I feel like it worked with me this time, and I'm just very happy for this performance.
What'd you say to your opponent?
My opponent's amazing. I have a new best friend, Jeremiah Yeager. I mean, thank you, him and his team. He's a warrior, and so much respect for people who are able to enter this ring and talk like he did. I love when fighters talk. It's entertaining, so I love it.
Everybody's got a best friend with them. Both you guys, where do you want to go from here?
Well, definitely, I still need to improve my defense. I still need to improve my control, my spacing, my timing. There's a lot. It's my fourth fight. I'm happy with the improvements thus far, but there's still a long way to go.
Thank you, fellas. Appreciate it. Bernardo, back to you.
Always good to see when a young fighter can be self-critical. Look at